Christopher is brain damaged. He is institutionalized because he cannot take care of himself. Yet Christopher taught himself to read, write, and communicate in more than 15 languages.
And can you tell me what that says, Steve? Very good.
What's striking about Christopher is, on the one hand, his ability to master languages and his inability to solve ordinary problems.
Professor Neil Smith is co-author of The Mind of a Savant, Language Learning and Modularity. He has spent years studying Christopher.
Christopher is now 35 years old. He's been living in sheltered accommodation for many years because he can't look after himself. He has very serious problems of hand-eye coordination. He can't do up his own buttons. He can't shave himself. He can't cross the road alone. He can't dress himself. He's not particularly well adapted to living at all on his own. He has an IQ that ranges between 40 and 120, depending on how you test it.
Barely able to function in every other respect, Christopher has a genius for language, to the point where he can read upside down and sideways just as well as he can read right side up.
He is very fluent in languages like French, German, Spanish, Italian, modern Greek, Polish. He's reasonably good in languages like Dutch and Hindi. It's very hard to tell. He's got quite a good knowledge of Turkish, not such a good knowledge of Finnish, a little bit of Welsh. We've taught him some Berber and a number of other languages as well. And these languages are written with various different scripts. So modern Greek and Russian and Hindi use three different scripts, none of them the Roman script.
The combination of Christopher's limited personal skills with his heightened language skills is unique.
Most savants have no talent for language. In fact, most of them have very impoverished language. But with Christopher, his one talent is languages. And when he meets you, he wants to know how many languages you speak. It's usually his first question.
Christopher's limitations can create problems, but his skills sometimes save the day.
One of his difficulties is that he gets lost very easily. When his sister took him on holiday to Mallorca some years ago, they went to their hotel, and after a few minutes, Christopher was lost, and so they were obviously worried about where he was. A few minutes later, they found him. He was happily talking to the German tourists and translating between German and Spanish to help them. He couldn't find his way to his bedroom, but he could act as interpreter for German tourists between Spanish and German.